Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good morning to all of you. Hope you're doing fine. Teacher Fayyazuddin Ahmed here. Today we are going to continue with the part 2 of the lesson Earth and Sun. This is lesson number 1 in chapter 8 of your Macmillan and McGraw-Hill series. So can you please open your science reading book, page number 362. Just a brief review of the vocabulary which we discussed in the last session. Rotation, the act of spinning. In this lesson, we are going to study about the Earth's rotation. And the axis, a real or imaginary line that an object spins around. And we deal with the Earth's axis here, which is tilted. And revolution, when one object travels around another object, we call it as a revolution. In this lesson, we are going to study about the Earth's revolution around the Sun. Orbit, the path a revolving object takes. And here we are going to study about the Earth's orbit, which is shaped like an ellipse or flattened circle. The Earth's orbit is in elliptical shape or a flattened circle. So it's not circular. To begin with this part now, what causes seasons? The Earth's tilted axis and its revolution around the Sun cause seasons. The Earth's tilted axis and its revolution around the Sun cause seasons. So Earth takes 365 and a quarter days or 1 year to complete one revolution. So Earth takes 1 year to complete one revolution. So it is 365 and a quarter days to complete one revolution. So during this revolution, and also because of the tilted axis of the Earth, the seasons are caused. We see the tilted axis here in this picture. The Earth's axis is tilted. It's not straight, but it's tilted. And this causes the sunlight to strike the Earth at different angles. See here, the sunlight is from this direction. And because of this tilted axis, the sunlight strikes the Earth at different angles. We all know there are four seasons. There are summer, fall, spring, and winter seasons. The Earth's tilt causes these summer seasons. In June, North Pole tilts towards the Sun, and sunlight strikes the northern hemisphere at steep angles, and hence the light is more intense. It is summer. In June, the northern part of the Earth, the North Pole, it tilts towards the Sun, so the northern hemisphere, it receives the sunlight at steep angles, and hence the sunlight is more intense in this area, and it is summer in June. In December, North Pole is tilted away from the Sun. In December, the North Pole, it is tilted away from the Sun, and the sunlight strikes the northern hemisphere at a low angle. The sunlight strikes the northern hemisphere at low angles, and here the intensity of the sunlight is less. It is not that intense as compared to that in June, but the sunlight intensity is low here, and it is winter during this period. And at the same time, it is summer in the southern hemisphere. We'll have a look at the picture here. It shows the revolution of this Earth around the Sun, and this is the axis, the tilted axis of the Earth. So we'll begin from here. Here the northern pole is tilted towards the Sun. So just now we saw that this is the intense part of the sunlight here. The sunlight strikes at a steep angle, and hence the northern pole, the North Pole or the northern hemisphere, it is experiencing the summer season here. And the southern part is experiencing the winter season here. Now coming back to this part, here we see the northern part is facing towards the Sun. So this is autumn in the northern hemisphere, and the southern hemisphere has spring season at the same time. And in this point, we see the southern pole is tilted towards the Sun. So it is summer in the southern hemisphere, and it is winter in the northern hemisphere. And in this part, we see the northern hemisphere is away from the sun and the southern hemisphere is facing towards the sun. So this is autumn in the southern hemisphere and spring in the northern hemisphere. So how does the sun's apparent path change over the seasons? So every season, the sun's apparent path, it keeps on changing. So the sun rises much higher in the summer day. In a summer day, the sun rises much higher. And also during summer, the sun rises earlier and sets later. The sun rises earlier and sets later. At the equator, the sun's apparent path is not much different during the seasons. The sun's apparent path, it changes very little during the year. And almost for all year, the sunlight strikes at similar angles. So because the sun's apparent path is not much different in different seasons, the sunlight, it strikes at similar angles the whole year. At the poles, near the poles, the sun's apparent path is very different between seasons. Unlike equator, here near the poles, the sun's apparent path is very different between seasons. In northern Alaska, the summer nights are very short, and during winter, the sun hardly appears. This is the sun's apparent path changing during the seasons. We'll just have a look at the picture here. Here we have three different seasons. We have a winter season where we saw the sun at the lowest level here. It's rising not much higher. When we're seeing the spring or autumn season, the sun is at an intermediary level. It's moderate, not high and not low. But in summer, we saw the sun is rising very high. So this is the difference between the seasons, sun's apparent path. And we see the difference in the shadows also. When we see the shadow in winter season, it is very long. We see the winter shadows are long, and in the autumn or spring, the shadows are moderate. It depends on the height at which the sun is rising. And during summer, as the sun is rising higher, the shadow is very short here. This is summer shadow. This is autumn and spring shadow, and this is winter shadow, which is very long. So this is the sun's apparent path. Actually, this is an apparent, as we studied in the last session, this is just an apparent motion. It's not the real motion. This is just what appears to us from the earth. It is not the truth. It is not the fact. Making predictions. We know the sun's apparent path changes in the same pattern every year. The sun's apparent path changes in the same pattern every year. So scientists use these patterns to make predictions. They can predict the exact time the sun will rise and set. They can predict the exact time the sun will rise and set. So this is the end of the topic. Hope you understood this topic. And please read your reading book, page number 362, 63 and 64. And I'll get back to you with the science workbook pages as soon as possible. Thank you. Have a nice day.